There are some things that can literally destroy your computer instantly. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month of August. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Be sure to take advantage of the giveaway, and with all the money and time that we put into our computers, which is a lot, we obviously want to keep them safe and secure. Well, if you want to keep your computer from dying an early death, you better keep these things away from it at all costs. Computers are very, very vulnerable. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to the Late Night Top 10, otherwise known as the Late Night Squad. And today, or tonight, we are going to be counting down the top 10 things that can definitely destroy your computer. Be sure to keep these things away from any electronics that you may have. Make sure you're subscribed with notifications on, click the little bell, check the box, so you never miss a late night video. And away we go. Now we are going to be going over things that can destroy your computer. Not necessarily somebody coming in and plugging in like a USB that melted or anything like that. And number 10, these are simple things that a lot of people they don't do right, or they do and they shouldn't. Shoving the disk tray. If you're one of those people who still uses disks instead of digital downloads, this one applies to you. I mean, I know you're in the minority, but I've seen it happen with my own eyes. A pretty common thing with a lot of people is to shove the disk tray closed instead of just pushing the button. Stop it. This will 100% damage the disk tray down the line and force you to have to replace it if you still use disk trays. Just wait the extra second and a half, people, and push the button to close it. We are not cavemen. We have technology. Have a little bit of patience and it will take care of itself. Number 9, using the internet without a firewall. This should be a default in everybody's head, but it's not. Every computer that is connected to the internet should absolutely have some form of a firewall running, be it a firewall built into your home router or a firewall that's built into your computer yourself. If you do not have one protecting your internet browsing experience, you are leaving yourself wide open to hackers, viruses, and identity theft. Let me paint a picture for you. It's the zombie apocalypse, okay? And there's walkers all outside your house and your yard everywhere. They're just walking around trying to find a way in. And basically, you open the front door and you put an air horn at the floor at the front door and you turn it on. That is basically what you could be doing if you do not operate with a firewall on your computer. I mean, trust me, you go out and use Wi-Fi that's not protected or secured, always have a firewall. Protect your computer. Another no-brainer, and a lot of these videos, a lot of these tips are no-brainer tips, but you would be surprised how many people don't know them. And number 8, not running antivirus. This one is obviously, it should be common knowledge, right? If you're not running any kind of antivirus, I hate to say it, but you are kind of asking for something to come in and wreck your computer. Sure, some antivirus programs can be a pain to install and manage, but I think the amount of help that they do, it is worth a few minutes of frustration during the setup process. Get some good antivirus and keep it running at all times. Your PC will thank you. And anytime you buy a PC or a laptop, they give you a trial, or some of them will even give you a full-fledged on antivirus program. So find the one that works best for you, do your research, and then make sure it's on your computer. Once again, common knowledge at number 7, but you'd be surprised how many people actually plug straight into the wall. Plugging in your computer, your baby, without surge protection. Because of all the power that goes through your computer every time it's plugged in, you don't have the proper means to compensate for that energy. You can actually ruin your PC. If you have multiple things plugged into the same circuit at your computer, an electrical surge can end up doing some damage or total damage to it. Like if you have a power outage and then the power comes back on, you get a surge protector to keep this from happening and ruining your PC. You can't have surges of electricity going in. It doesn't function well with that. Basically, just don't plug your PC directly into the wall. Always plug it into a surge protector that is then plugged into the wall. And most surge protectors have the little light where you can actually see if they are functioning and doing what they need to. It's an easy one. It only costs like 10 bucks to get one. Definitely get one. You don't want to be the guy that lightning hits and then your computer's trash. At number six, not restarting after updates and installs. We're pretty used to our computers restarting after a software update. It's part of the reason why it takes so long. But did you know that you should technically be doing that before every install? Not restarting after installing new programs or software, it can actually damage the new stuff and put a strain on your PC. Whenever you download something new, something of importance, an update or a program, always restart your computer after it finishes. This will keep things running nice and smooth. Everything gets a fresh reboot. You'll see a lot of installs that prompt you and say you will need to restart. Well, they're doing that for a reason. So maybe take it upon yourself for anything that doesn't prompt you to still do it, because that is what the computer wants. When you get emails from a random person that you don't know, there's a good chance it contains something malicious. Cracking into the top five today, opening all attachments. This one can obliterate your computer, which most of you know. How do you avoid it? Well, I don't have a secret formula for you guys. It's really easy. Don't open something that looks suspicious. I mean, I don't know what else to tell you. It may seem like common knowledge to you, but there are so many people that just open attachments blindly from people they don't know. Stop it. If you get an email full of attachments and you do not recognize the person it's from, don't open it. Problem solved. I promise you, it's not somebody that's going to give you $1 million. It's not some bank in Zimbabwe that says you are the royal heir to $18 million. You just have to open and fill out this form or click this link. I promise you, if it walks like a duck, it talks like a duck, it's a duck. And if it's a duck in this case, it's a malicious duck. It can ruin your computer. Number four goes without saying, but a lot of people abuse this. Not cleaning your PC. Computers get very, very hot due to how powerful they are. Because of this, you should always have a fan inside your PC, of course, which most computers have built in, but that doesn't mean the process stops there. Every once in a while, you should get into your computer, take all care of all the dust that may be blocking the airways. You'd be surprised what a little dust bunny can do to the performance of your PC. A fan won't do much if there's airways that are blocked by dust or other gunk that may be in there. Failing to keep your computer clean will lead to internal damage or overheating. It will just end up forcing you to have to buy new parts. Remember to clean it from time to time. What I do is usually once a month, I lie, usually two every 2 months. I'll unhook everything. I'll take my computer's huge. I'll take it outside. I'll take the panels off the side. I'll get two or three cans of air and I will go to town and just clean it of all dust. And every computer is going to get dusty. So definitely, definitely maintenance your computer. At number three, let's stick with cleaning, and I just said clean your computer, but you can't clean it the way you clean other things in your house. Do not use Windex on your monitor. Cleaning with solvent, people. It will absolutely ruin the display and grant you with some permanent smudges across your screen. In fact, you're better off using your own spit to clean your computer gear than something with no chemicals in it. I'm being serious. Using saliva as a cleaning substance isn't actually a horrible idea. My point is, always Google what's safe and what's not safe for your computer. Never use something to clean it that you are not 100% positive it won't damage it. We all know how expensive computers are. You don't want to have to replace parts or anything like that because you tried to use Windex on your computer. Just imagine you're taking a shower and you pour acid on your skin to clean it. That's the same reference to stuff that you're not supposed to clean your electronics with. So make sure you use the right thing. I have a whole box of touchscreen wipes that are specifically for electronics that I use for my monitors, keyboard, and mouse. At number two, clicking everything. This is another one that is common knowledge to many of you, but may not be to somebody that stumbles across this video. Don't click away when you're online. My wife does this. There's so much filth on the internet, some harmless, some not harmless. Don't click on everything that you see, as much of it will be redirected, downloaded, or uploaded. You will not be able to go back. You ever been caught in that loop where you go to the wrong site, something pops up on the screen, but as soon as you exit out, it comes right back up? There is a little thing you can do. You could Control-Alt-Delete, go to Task Manager, and end the process there, but a lot of people get stuck there, and they think they have to click stuff just to download, and by then, they're done. Just click things you want to click on. Don't be an octopus grabbing everything that you see online. The biggest thing that could wreck your computer and everything about it is not having a backup. Even if you follow every bit of our advice today, your computer may still end up crashing on you. It happens to the best of them, and if you've planned ahead for this unlikely event, a crashing computer shouldn't be a huge deal. But if you don't have a backup of your files, you're pretty much screwed. If you have important things on your computer and they're not anywhere else, you need to change that right now. Get a USB drive or an external, whatever. Run it once a week. I run mine on Sundays. Back up your files. This way, if your computer crashes or is compromised, you won't be completely boned and you'll still have access to the important things on your old PC. Windows Image Backup, I believe, is what it's called. Super, super important. Could save you, because computers, they're man-made. They are going to break. No computer is going to last forever. So be prepared ahead of time to have all that precious cargo that you've saved on your computer somewhere where you can put it on a brand new one. There you have it, my friends. Those are 10 things that can absolutely destroy your computer. If you guys would like us to go into more details and tell you 10 malicious things that could destroy your computer, definitely let me know. There's a playlist below with all the other late night top 10s that go up. Thank you for all the support on this series. Be sure to make sure you're subscribed. And drop a like on the video, and I'll see you guys on the next one.